For me, the way I've been looking at gender in terms of Indian classical dance performances, my experience is really coming from my time in the UK, which has a massive South Asian dance scene. And what was amazing, whether it was Bharatanatyam, Odissi, or Kathak dancers, whenever they would want to explain what makes their dance authentic, culturally speaking, it would be to point to Vajra. If you can capture Vajra, if you can be coy in your performance, then you're performing authentically. We have this fixing of a definition tied to this idea of feminine Vajra, even as we have dancers saying, well, no, wait a minute, there's many different ways of exploring oneself and defining gender, right? There's many, many forms of femininity and masculinity. And so what you see happening when we start to look at the professionalization of dance, that's another gender difference that we do need to talk about. Because even as it's women who are overwhelmingly the ones who are transmitting the dance and passing it down along the generations, the professionalization of it is very much about recognizing male dancers. So many of us are here because of that generation of women dancers who came, established schools, taught classes in their homes, and really made sure that presence was here in the diaspora. But what we see happening now, it is the men who are the ones who are recognized. Again, because the question of culture is tied to femininity. So I'm not saying that that is the definition of culture, but I'm saying that's the definition that we're forced to operate under. And we need to acknowledge that in order to find ways of moving forward. This is not to say that women don't produce contemporary Indian classical dance either. What they do, what you do, what we're all here doing is incredibly contemporary. But to have that stamp of approval, that big C contemporary, it's still coming from this very patriarchal position of women do cultural dance and men do professional dance.